Hey guys, it's Queenisha, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episodes 42 and 43 of Yes, Pretty Cure 5. So let's go ahead and get started with episode 42. In 3, 2, 1, go. Perfect. So beautiful. Maybe above. I mean, it would be obvious because you two are so good at flowers, so that would make the most sense. Sure out. No, don't you not like that? Oh my God. Now is not the time to argue, girls. Oh, this is so adorable. No. Not as much as your run. And plus, it seems natural to you. I get that. Right. Who already know what they want to do for the rest of their lives. Yeah. Oh. I mean, you know, you're not wrong about that, but shut up. Exactly. So kind of makes you wonder why knows me and everybody else is taking so long. Unfortunately. And that's okay. They're just perfect for each other. That's good. It's a little bit of both. They just so freaking cute. I mean, to have an episode like this, I think even at the time when it was airing, was really good for a lot of people because, of course, even at like a young age, even into your early to your late 20s, where you're like, I don't know what I want to do. And everybody goes somewhere to find themselves, essentially. And so we know that by the end of this series overall, they are going to have their dreams. Technically, their dreams are already there. And it's making other people happy. Now, if Rin also decides to do, like, okay, she wants to still be an athlete at the same time, or basically professional, but then also work as a florist would be good. That's two jobs in one. But at the same time with something like that, how are you going to be able to multitask and balance? There are some people who are really able to do that, and then there are people who, as much as they can try and everything, they just can't. And it does suck, really. With baby Cotton and Milk saying to her that, you know, when she was sick, she took care of her. And that just tells you once again, like, Cotton's gonna be the best mother when she gets older. And I honestly love that. I mean, all five of them have, like, kind of, you know what? No, let me take that back. Four out of the five have motherly figures. I mean, yeah, four of them have that motherly touch. Nozomi, you're not there yet, baby. You need a little bit longer. I mean, because I can't imagine if Milk got sick again and Nozomi's like, I'll take care of her this time, but like, excited, but yeah, honestly, everybody got the motherly touches up Nozomi. When it comes to pretty care things, Nozomi is very mature, but when it comes to regular duty things, like, that girl is like, no, I'm good. But gotta pause the video, and I'll see you guys in 1 second for episode 43. Okay, episode 43, and 3, 2, 1, go. Yeah, because it is a problem that she has to figure out on her own, you know? Poor baby. Right. Yeah, but how much are you really gonna do that? Excuse me. Yeah, put two and two together. Make that four. Well, because unfortunately you have been failing, ma'am. See, you say that, but no offense. That's a little excuse in my book. Pinky? Yeah, Pinky. Oh, hon. Okay. This story. You mean nuts, right? Yes, but you know, she feels a little embarrassed. I mean, come on, she's a girl, of course, and she has like the biggest crush on you. I get that, but come on now. Happiness. No, hon. Yeah, we all are. That poor Pinky. Shut up. Oh, God. I'm hungry. I'm gonna cook dinner after this. Excuse me. Well, you unfortunately were taking too long. God. Exactly. That's right. You want to break the crap out of your hand. See, that just tells you, like, Komachi is way too freaking OP that she knows that she is. Like, she limits herself, but now, like, oh, baby! Of course. Once again, this child doesn't realize how OP she is. Like, oh my God. Like, for really the relationship of Nes and Komachi, still, it's a better relationship than Coco and Nozomi, in my opinion. Because even though, like, Nozomi and Coco are, like, adorable together, even though at the same time he is older than her. Like, just the nuts and the komaji, it just works. They just are so freaking similar to each other, even though sometimes Nets can be a little hard-ass, and you just want to slap the crap out of him. But he only, the things that he does, he's only doing it because out in the real world, this is how people act. In the real world, people really don't give a crap about you or who you are, this is that and the third. You have to defend for yourself. And I get it. Almost in a way, Komachi has writer's block with the fact is that she cannot figure out how she wants her last scene to go. It's very similar to, like, anyone else who has writer's block and where they have, like, in the beginning, so many good ideas. And then once they get to a certain age or even at, like, their first few years of being an author and they're at something where, at a stage where they cannot figure out, like, what they want to do next. And sometimes you have to take a break from it and then come back to it. I mean, hell, I should know because there was one time where I wrote fan fiction of this couple that I shipped. I did two books and I lost interest. I couldn't figure out like what the heck I wanted to do next with it. And I kind of stopped. And even till today, I will get messages and everything else like saying, oh, hey, when are you going to continue it? But I'm never continuing it because I don't know what else I would want to write with it, you know? Can you believe we're also in the final six episodes of this show? Like, oh my god. It just feels so nuts and, like, crazy that we are very, very close to being done with this and everything. And I hate the fact that we're getting so close to it because it's such a damn good show. And I love the fact that, you know, people are enjoying this rewatch, whether it's Patreons, non-Patreons, whoever. And I'm really glad that everybody is just enjoying this and such. But, like, we know that by the end of this, like, Komachi, Karin, Rin, Urara, and knows me, their dreams will come true. It's a lot of work to figure out, like, essentially the steps that you have to do, and then plus all the consequences and everything, problems and such, that you are going to face with doing whatever you want into your career. And that's why it's truly best to either have close friends or loved ones to be there when you are at your lowest point so that they can help you get back up. And I even love the fact that, you know, in his own way, Nuts tried to give her advice and said, yeah, you can sometimes be carefree, like knows me, but not too, too carefree because, you know, knows me and it's just knows me. We all freaking know that at the end of the day, no matter what. But other than that, guys, that's my reaction view towards episodes 42 and 43 of Yes, Pretty Cure 5. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. It really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Master Squad. And, of course, I will see you guys officially on next Friday for Patreons and next Monday for everybody else for episodes 44 and 45. Bye, guys.